Hello dear friends, welcome at my next video. This is actually a video made from my photos which I made during my visit of Malta Islands, so Malta and Gozo. I was there for to do better documentations for my researches especially tied with Malta's megalithic temples. Why are so interesting those temples? They are very old. What are on the surface of Malta? They are 5, 7, maybe 8,000 years old, and there are some which are under the sea level. So maybe those are even 10,000 or more years old. I started my visit, but with other sightings. Next to my hotel, there are interesting places, so-called beehives. Actually are beehives which were used during Phoenician Roman times. Not classical wooden, but made to the stone. Malta is covered or made mainly from limestone, so it is quite soft, but easy for to do various constructions like this. Malta Melita connected with honey. There are many trees around there, so-called carob trees, and also close to this place is one of the oldest trees, 2000 years old. Okay. There is also made pavement, and it was used for various pilgrimages also in Roman times, when after visit of Apostle Paul this island was Christianized, and there are Christians till now, mainly big part of population. My daughter, so it's quite green island, though there are lot of stone constructions. This is under that very old carob tree. I started my visit of megalithic temples in Valletta, capital city. So on Malta there are many fortresses, many churches, especially from time of Middle Ages, when Malta was actually one fortress, and Malta was very successful under Johannes in wars with Arabs, Turks, with Ottoman Empire. And this is in the first temple which I visited over there. It's Tarxien. Tarxien is made from quite big heavy constructions. Those temples were discovered, or not discovered, but excavated, especially during ages since 1910-12, during First World War, were done big excavations, and they found many old megalithic temples from quite heavy blocks and tons. There are also many carvings, especially tied with shifts. Okay, when those sheaves are similar to sheaves what were used in Egypt, old Kemet, okay? And there are many some such signs which are like waves, but there is description of how waves are spreading through the sea or through the air. Yes, this is very nice. What I found over there especially interesting is fact that those temples were used like acoustic weapons or for acoustic communication on long or for long distances. How long? Maybe 60 kilometers, maybe even more. They were used like weapons, so on particular places in those temples were placed singers, so-called sirens in legends, okay? And that sound, their singing was amplified, and enemy ships, crews of enemy ships were afflicted by the sound, and they jumped to the water with madness. Many holes are there maybe for tuning, okay? So quite big and very old constructions. Also those signs of waves. Quite big megaliths. So here we see, for example, this Hotarxian temple on the scheme of the temple. Yes. So what is interesting on those temples? That we have over there three types of temples which looks like generators of electromagnetic or other waves, generators and amplifiers. One sort is which looks like multi-cavity klystron, reflex klystron. What kind of instrument it is? That instrument is used, for example, in radars or could be in microwave ovens and such devices. So it looks like more like guitar or violins connected together. So here was this signal amplified, and there are even other stages for more amplification, so for better amplification, and there is such wall in that U shape which is used for beaming of that sound to the particular area, like antenna, yes? This is in Hotarxian, okay? And here are statues, rest of statues, which were excavated. So there were big persons, women, two women, standing on such pedestals. Here is also sign of sound, okay, of waves, and they were singing special songs or producing special sounds which were amplified by the whole temple, okay. Those women were very big, bigger than normal population, very not strong but very fat. But probably that sound was such like our opera divas have, so they are able to crash, for example, glasses and so on, okay, with their sound. probably it was race of humans or not common noun type of humans, maybe those Anunnakis, Nephilim, or their mixlings with people, which were very big, and they had got also those prolongated heads. There were found also such skulls, but they were in museum, but those skulls were borrowed by Rockefeller Foundation and not returned back. So such way. Or they, it's not possible to see those skulls now. But there are many such balls over there, because Malta is full of such so-called cart routes. It looks like railway in the stone, and on those railway lines were used such big balls, and on those balls probably those megaliths were moved. So those cart routes are even older than those temples. Okay, again, mine view. Detail on one of such room inside the temple and Taxian. Okay. Taxian in actually in area where are buildings around, and quite close is also the cave system, which is called Hippogeum. Very similar structure like those temples on the surface, but underground, and there are more levels underground. According that some articles call for tuning or for connecting of doors or so on. Okay, okay, these are tuning holes probably, like on the pipe. This is shape how those temples looked like. Okay, there was roof, okay, opening doors and big walls. Very fast, very heavy construction to hold such big energy what was produced over there. Well, and here are some small balls which were used in those lines for to do transport of blocks, make easier, okay, like on wheels. This is covered with some like blankets, but due to prevent erosion. This is the town Valletta. So many historical temples are there, very big, very nicely decorated. So here again on the road. here we see another temple which is in Gigantia on island Gozo. Very heavy construction. Walls are even supported with extra material for to withhold that energy, for to amplify it better. Here is it, frequency curve graph, how for example violin works or guitar works. So those are smaller instruments which are 50 centimeter long or to 1 meter long, amplify signals and produce an amplified signal circa from, for example, 150 till 10,000 hertz. Yes, okay. There are peaks where those instruments work better, but it works so. But when we have such big temple, it works similar, but due to dimensions which are 10 times bigger than such instrument, okay, so it amplifies from circa 5 to 10 hertz till circa 1000 hertz. So this graph is shifted to this place, okay, circa so, okay. See, those are very low tones, sounds were amplified, especially tones on frequencies around 5, 7, 10, 12 hertz are influences our brains, so-called brain waves. Okay. Like hypnotization is possible. Okay. That's a scheme of another sort of amplifier, so-called magnetron. Magnetron is used also in radar, in radars, microwave ovens, like generator of electromagnetic waves. And there are such temples, there is some such temple on Malta which looks similar. Cart routes. Those cart routes are over there on the Malta island. Okay, you see. And those cart routes go to the sea, and there are even undersea, and there are some crosses of those cart routes. It looks like on a railway station, or on railway stations. So they were done probably 8, 10 and more thousands years ago. And here are waves which are produced, for example, on pipe. So that shape, like we see on those carvings, on those ornaments, on the decorations which are on temples. Okay. Carved roots. There are also many various holes. And here is also some such scheme of human organs. Human organs, lungs, and we have here mouth, and all our voice organs looks similar like those temples we see. Yes, for example, two. And this temple, this scheme of temple which is in neither, I think, okay. Such persons were placed here. It's like on the guitar, on the place where we are playing. So they were producing sound, and this was amplified by this complex. Okay. Maybe here were even some fires used, or something like draft, which even more amplified those sounds. And this shape was used like antenna for to beam it to particular place. On the sea or so on. So this statue or how those big women looked like. Okay. This is scheme of, for example, that multi-cavity klystron, like that Taxian temple. So more temples connected one after another. Again carvings. Here's other skin from other place which was used for healing, but similar system. Panenský Tinec in Czech Republic. One for monks was used, temple which was used for healing. Here we have again such signs, scheme for example of how guitar looks like. Okay, like that temple, and where we are playing, there were those pedestals for persons, and they were singing. Okay, again all the shifts. Here is another temple. This is the Hadzar Kim and Mnaidra, these are close one to another. So many photos that it's next. Quite big blocks, but that erosion is enormous. So after many years, blocks which were not under soil are quite heavy eroded. Again. This is scheme of that Nidra, I think. Okay. So like violin or guitar shaped temples. Here are these pedestals for singers. Okay. And the sound was amplified, heavy constructions, so those are blocks. Are quite heavy, and even support from extra material was there. And here were arches for more amplification or for beaming of the sound to the sea or to the particular places, other particular places for communication, for example. Okay. We have also legend about these temples, which is probably connected with Malta's temples. So, during Odyssey time, when he was prisoner on the island Gozo, Ogygia. Ogygia is actually Gozo. He was prisoner in love of nymph Callisto. That nymph Callisto, when Odyssey was allowed to go home, was warned. When you go next to or past next island, so there are so-called sirens, and if you not push wax or something to the ears of your crew, so you can be destroyed by those sirens, by their sound. So Odyssey wanted to hear that sound, so he was tied to the mast, and other persons from his crew, their ears were fixed with waxes, and so they weren't able to hear that sound, or to prevent to jump to the sea with madness. That cave actually is on that Gozo island, north coast of island of Gozo. There is Callisto cave. You can see it over there too. Okay. The next pedestal, or what is it? Also signs of waves sound. This is also interesting, these doors, because they look like something similar to our subwoofer. Maybe there were doors or something like Kupfer plate or something which helped to resonate. Okay. Small island which was used but in Middle Ages for testing of cannons. Okay, that subwoofer door again. And this is construction of Hazarkim. Okay. This looks like that magnetron which I showed you some minutes ago, before this. Okay. So waves from these temples were amplified in such style and were pushed outside after it from this temple. Also, for example, Colosseum in Rome, we got some such similar, a little similar construction for to have very good acoustic properties. Okay, but this was generator, like that magnetron. Those temples were used also for astronomical purposes, for example, to observe solstices, equinoxes, or other, for example, position of Pleiades and other constellations, for to measure time. Okay. This model, actual model, but very precisely. Again, some blocks with big level of erosion, which blocks which were under surface are in quite good state, but those which were above soil on the surface are very heavy eroded. Erosion looks like on the surface of that island, okay. Pedestal again. Small dots, maybe also used for various measurements of this pedestal. Especially those astronomic measurements. Like some scale for measurement. And those are dots, probably maybe have also purpose. Also very nice tables, pedestals like altars. Inside of one of the temples. Also here is some such nice opening for tuning of some such purpose. Also here special openings, not round, but quite big blocks are there. Some of them are quite big, really. View on the sea. This is south coast when there are quite big waves. Very dangerous for sailing the south coast. North coast is more flat and there are beaches. And some stones are such way decorated with small dots, small holes. Maybe from acoustic reasons, for to manipulate with sound, or maybe astronomical reason. I think more probably is that acoustical reason. So not. I tried to swim somewhere one day, but it wasn't very possible because that south coast is not very suitable. Big waves and. Also on the coast there are many caves, many openings in those cliffs. Very unusual plants are over there also. Not typical for other islands. Which are used now by birds. Not so easy to go there. So some of the caves are nearly without access. This is a reconstruction how those temples had been built, but maybe so, maybe other way. It's not clear. But those cart routes probably were used for transport. Those blocks. This scheme, how those temples were built. So, firstly, there were built probably doors and that part, after it those walls, yes, those walls, and after it the roof was made like here. Temples or in the museums next to the temples which were excavated on those places. And here is also depiction of that temple, probably from the time when the temple was built. Okay, here are walls, roof. The original depiction of the wall. And here is one stone probably with some measurements of equinoxes, solstices or other astronomical observations. Yes. These rows of dots in various part of year measurements were done. Day after day or so. This is pavement from Hadžarkin to Njajdra temple, which is close to the coast, or on the coast. Era played, so probably some instruments were done with help of constellation of players. Again, depiction of the temple. This is view from the ship on the next island of the visit. So this is on Gozo Island, and this is that Gigantia temple, also very old, very heavy construction, rest of some such figure of statue, reconstruction of whatever used temples or. And here are many such in that museum, many such statues of persons, of women, probably those that siren singers on that island, Gozo. And also those shamans or who were those, we don't know exactly, statues of those persons. So some photos from Gozo, again Gigantia. Many churches, 1, 2, 3, a lot of 50, 60 churches, and smaller or bigger fortresses over the Gozo, over the whole Malta, against the pirates, against the Turks, Arabs or Normans, Vikings. This is from the pavement, pilgrims' crosses, which was next to my hotel where I was standing. And there are also many smaller caves. Okay, bigger caves and so on. So, thank you very much for your attention. What to say on the end? So this place is interesting due to such temples which have three construction types, three sort of generators. Was it only accidental that there are such three various sorts of acoustic or of other sort of generators? I think not. Also those cart routes are interesting, which were used for transport. Very interesting is that cave system, that hypogeum also with very good acoustic properties. For example, in 30 years, in 1930s, there was some class with children, with teacher, and suddenly they were missed in those cave system and were not found till now. And people heard sounds crying of those children over there, but were not found till now. And they had seen special creatures over there, according some people who were living over there next to Hippogeum. So that cave system was interesting. It was used against the floods, enemies with special doors. So maybe even during floods was possible to survive. But some survived, some not, because there were found also many thousands of bones, skeletons. So Malta is full of secrets. Okay. another secret is that, especially on Gozo, there is one family. I tried to find them, but wasn't successful. But on the old photos, there were those persons which had got signs of those original giant race which was living there. Some longer and thicker throats, bigger heads, quite big statues, and especially one family. Maybe they have some genes from that race. I'm not sure. But probably. I wanted to arrange also not trip but diving, because there was one person which I was communicated in previous century, yes, in 1990s, 80s, 70s, he was diving and he made a lot of interesting photos of rest of temples which are under sea level, maybe 10, 20 and more meters, because Malta Island was much bigger before 5, 7, 8 thousand years, when water level was 10 and more meters lower. 10,000, 12,000 years ago, Malta's area was n times bigger than it is now. Okay, so those are temples which are under sea level, but maybe 40, maybe till 100 meter low, are very old, 10, 12 and more thousand years old. So thank you very much for attention. So it was Pavel Smutny with my next video, okay, with this presentation. So see you later, thank you very much again.